That's what it is. Read what you got, brother.
James chapter 1, verse 25.
Read what it say, brother.
But whoso looketh into the perfect law of liberty.
Of what?
Liberty.
Of freedom. Liberty is freedom. Read.
And continueth therein. He being not a forgetful hearer.
You know what? People hear this Bible and they forget about it. Time they stop hearing the Bible, they start doing something else. But God say, be not a forgetful hearer.
That's right.
Read.
But a doer.
But a what?
A doer.
No, I can do my own thing.
A doer.
Read.
Of the work.
But a doer of the what?
Of the work.
But a doer of the work, brothers and sisters. Put your hard hats on. We got work to do for the Most High God.
That's right.
We got work to do to show him that we love him by keeping his laws, statutes, and commandments. We can't show God we love him no other way.
That's right.
But to keep his laws, statutes, and commandments. Read, brother.
This man shall be blessed in his deed.
He shall be what?
Blessed in his deed.
If a man do the works of the Most High God, he's going to be blessed in the things that he do.
That's right.
That's what this Bible is telling us. But you still got people that think they in charge gonna tell you to be quiet. No, we've been quiet too long. It's time up to lift up our voice. Not saying, but lift up our voice and speak this truth. Not going out there protesting and marching with the enemy, but doing what it is, this truth. Not no Black Lives Matter, not no White Lives Matter, but the truth matters. This what matters, this truth. Because this is gonna set you free. Nothing else. Black Lives Matter ain't gonna set you free. White Lives Matter ain't gonna set you free. Only this truth, brothers and sisters, is gonna set you free.
That's right.
Free, brother.
Exodus chapter 23, verse 25.
Read, brother.
And ye shall serve the Lord your God.
And you shall serve the Lord your God.
And he shall bless thy bread.
And he shall bless thy bread.
And thy water.
And thy water.
And I will take sickness away from the midst of thee.
And he will take sickness from the midst of you. So all y'all hollering about y'all believe that coronavirus stuff, read that scripture again, brother. Let's see what the Most High God say that he'll do for you if you obey him.
Verse 25.
Read.
And ye shall serve the Lord your God.
You shall serve the Lord your God.
And he shall bless thy bread.
And he shall bless thy bread.
And thy water.
And thy water.
And I will take sickness.
And he will take sickness
away from the midst of thee.
From the midst of you. That's what he say. He say that he will take the sickness from the midst of you if you obey him.
That's right.
Because there's nothing that God cannot defeat. There's nothing that they can put out here with that lie talking about the coronavirus. Ain't no damn coronavirus. Stop believing that lie. Stop believing those lies they tell you. And come back to your God. That's what the Bible say. That's what the Bible is telling us. Want to believe all that bullshit? Start believing the truth. Come back to your God.
That's right.
That's what this Bible is talking about. But nobody wants to believe the truth. Everybody wants to believe a bunch of bullcrap. Nobody want to believe what God says.
That's right.
Everybody want to believe what the white man say. But nobody wants to believe what God says. Read, brother.
Surah chapter 38, verse 15.
Read what the Bible say, brother.
He that sinneth before his maker.
The Bible say he that does what?
He that sinneth before his maker.
The Bible say he that sinneth before his maker.
Let him fall into the hand of the physician.
The Bible say he that do what? Read that scripture again, brother.
Verse 15. He that sinneth before his maker.
The Bible say he that sinneth before his maker.
Let him fall into the hand of the physician.
Let him fall into the hands of the physician. Read it again.
verse 15.
Read.
He that sinneth before his maker.
He that sinneth before his maker. Your maker is God, Yahweh. Read.
Let him fall into the hand of the physician.
Let him fall into the hands of the physician. Like I said before, ain't no coronavirus. They tell you there ain't no cure for it. They say if you think you got it, go home and quarantine. So why would you go to the hospital? Because if you take 50 people that has been to the hospital for the coronavirus, you might have 46 or 47 that come back. But the rest of them, they're going to kill, brothers and sisters. That's what's happening. You better know this truth.
That's right.
The Bible say, he that believeth on me, like the scripture has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. That's what our God say. That's what the Bible says, brothers and sisters. You got to obey God. And he'll deliver you from all sicknesses and all diseases. That's what this Bible is saying.
Right.
We're not talking out our head. We're not speaking on emotions. We're coming out of the 1611 King James Bible.
Tell it.
That's where we're coming from. That's where we're coming at. Read what you got, brother.
Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 16.
Read what it say, brother.
In that I command thee.
What did he command us, brother?
This day.
What day?
This day.
This day the Lord said that he commanded thee.
To love the Lord thy God.
To love the Lord thy God.
To walk in his ways.
To walk in his ways.
And to keep his commandments.
And to keep his commandments.
And his statutes.
And his statutes.
And his judgment.
And his judgment.
That thy mightest live and multiply.
That I might live and multiply. Now what I want you to do, I want you to give me 1 John chapter 5 and verse 3. And let's see how we love God. Because everybody holler about they love God. But they don't even know how to love God. Because you can look at them and tell that they're not loving God by the way they look, by the way they dress, what they got on. Because there's things you got to do if you say you love God. Because you can't give him no Hershey's kisses. You can't send him no card.
That's right.
You can't give him no high five. You got to do some work. And what is that we got to do, brother?
Delete the lies and download the truth.
We got to delete the lies and download the truth, brothers and sisters. What does the Bible say in 1 John 5 and 3? How do you love God? Read.
1 John chapter 5, verse 3.
Read what the Bible says, brother.
For this is the love of Yahweh.
For this is the love of God. Read.
That we keep his commandments.
No, the commandments are done away with.
Keep his commandments.
No, Jesus nailed them on the cross.
Keep his commandments.
Read it from the beginning.
Verse 3. For this is the love of God.
Read.
That we keep his commandments.
That we do what?
Keep his commandments.
That we keep his commandments.
And his commandments are not grievous.
And his commandments are not hard. Read it again.
Verse 3.
Read.
For this is the love of God.
This is the love of God, brothers and sisters.
That we keep his commandments.
That we keep his commandments.
And his commandments are not grievous.
And his commandments are not grievous. Give me the book of Matthew 15 and 14. 14 and 15. Let's see what the Bible say that we got to do. See, it's all over the Bible. They're telling you in the churches that your commandments are done away with. That's to keep you in sin, brothers and sisters. You better get this truth before the Most High returns. You better practice the righteous acts before he turns. Because you don't know what day or hour he's going to return. So you better be ready and prepared when he comes. John. Give me John. That's what the Bible says. John. Read, brother. 14 and 15. Read that.
John chapter 14, verse 15.
Read.
If ye love me.
If you what?
If ye love me.
If you do what, brother?
If ye love me.
What I gotta do if I love him?
Keep my commandments.
Keep what?
Keep my commandments.
That's what the Bible says. If you love me, keep the commandments.
That's right.